Hi folks, Luca Chapatreza. A mixed day on Wall Street and a little bit negative. In fact, the day worked out very well until there was the report from the Feds that didn't paint a very pretty picture with the recovery, the economic recovery tied up in the virus. If we don't get hold of this virus, this is going to be a mess. And basically, that's how it came across. And so investors did not like the message and shouldn't be surprised, but there it is. Went down, one, two, three, wave down. In the after-hour market, we are seeing presence of just one lower shadow, upper shadow. This usually indicates lower movement. So we'll see tomorrow. One is not enough. If there are several, it's pressure. For now, it's holding the ATMA, but the dunbar volume increased significantly. So if this one picks up steam and breaks below the ATMA, we'll retest this low at 332, and then below that, the high at 329, and then 324. Take a look at individual stocks. We have several to cover. ADT. Broke the primary support at 11.50 and held the secondary support at 11. Today the low was 11.19. Still not confirming. This is an indecision with low volume. Even though it's green, picked up a little bit, but still. However, considering how the market closed, this might have a shot to reverse. The line in the sand is 11, and I need to see as soon as tomorrow, move and hold above 12. That will be the first step. Until then, this move could move sideways or down. B exploded yesterday and today extended as high as 18.59, and then I pull back on dunbar volume increase. Might pull back and retest this high at 15.64. Be right there, and if he holds, if he comes to half of yesterday candle and consolidates and maybe waits for the ATMA, that could be a good re-entry or entry opportunity. I'm looking for the test of the all-time high in 1950-67, and if he blows through it, it's 21 and 23. Support is the ATMA. Card, this was mentioned here a few times. I like this consolidation. And today, a move, the OBV crossed above the moving average. Look for a move above this high, 34.07. It will be first target. Above that, 37 and 41. Support is 31 and 29.80. Dollar tree in consolidation after the bit of a reversal yesterday, found a bounce above from the primary support at 98. Now that's the line in the sand. No more 95, 98, 98. I don't want anywhere below 90, 98. Today, an indecision and volume picked up a little bit. That's positive, but we need to see a better close. I'm looking for 108, I mean 107, 105.57, and 112. Facel, this following the electric vehicle spike, broke out yesterday. Today reached my target at 350. It was a large seller and came down very hard. Was the high as well at 342, big resistance. This still looks bullish. Might pull back and retest the three. It's a breakout on big volume. So let's see if the market cooperates. This could be an entry. Ideally, consolidates nicely. Maybe if we see some lower shadows and then the volume, you want to see a decreasing volume. Looking for a 385, 441, and 5. FTCH struggling with this 30 area. Dunbar volume picked up yesterday and today, but it's holding the 3MA and the 8MA. Primary support is 29, secondary support is 28. I need to see market cooperate and better technical with more green, not so much red. We saw 3 days here of red and rolled over and then broke. Now 2 days is moving sideways, so that's okay. Looking for 33 and 35. Gold not working. Gold is now got a bounce Yesterday, Kendo showed that it wasn't working. 30 was the primary support, 29 secondary support, and he took up both. So this is obviously not working. He might come down here and fill the gap, and the 50 simple the moving average. At that point, maybe a re-entry, but I don't like commodities. The only reason for entering this trade was large call flow. This was the intention. Follow up the following day with a breakout of this high, but it didn't follow through. So off. GRWG, this is blowing out the water. It was a day trade here, extended and recovered all along, it's been a day trade every day, basically. Today, exploding above the 20, that was the all-time high. There. And came as high as 23, almost 20. Yeah, 22.86. Big resistance, consolidation, that was my target, 22.22. It could extend, I mean, the technicals are bullish, very, lots of volume, look at this. 45 million traded shares. If it does extend, as I mentioned in the trading room, trade the hourly chart, if you swing, 24, 27 and 29, but again, follow the trend line. This is the bottom, this is your support, as well as the ATMA and the VWP. Home, we re-entered, working nicely. Took it off the list the day before yesterday with consolidation, or not yesterday. And because it was struggling to break the 17. And then today, started the day fantastic, with a fantastic move, big volume. So immediately, as soon as I saw, I send a message to the swing group as a re-entry opportunity, or if you stayed in a position that was breaking the 17 with volume. And immediately, after a little bit of a pullback consolidation, an entry opportunity near 1780, 1760 area, broke out and reached the target at 1889. And then went very strong for the rest of the day until a weekend into the close. 1956 was the high. This is a breakout big volume. If it extends 21 and 23, the support 1850 and 17. JD reached the first target, channel top. This could be a good place to start taking some profit already. I mean, you know, it's a small percent, but you know, this is gonna go higher, but it will pull back. So be aware of that. That's what I'm saying, take your profit, at least partial. I did today a little bit. And this is up from yesterday, it's an entry 70, yeah, up 5%, I mean, that's good, you know. And if it pulls back, we are now tightening stops 71 and 68, that remains the same. But it could pull back and test the ATMA and then the 65, be aware. There is a good support here at 69, so hopefully the area holds. But as you know, hopefully in trading doesn't work. If it breaks out, on the other hand, and extends, I'm looking, this is my second target, 77 and 82. LB, this one was a beautiful day trade and a trade idea that was mentioned in the videos multiple times. They reported earnings, blow out the water to 31. And then it's going down as the minutes tick. So this looks done. It's now at 28.50. So right here where it started. The technicals are still bullish. We'll have to see how tomorrow behaves. If he comes back and holds the 29.15 area, 31, 33, and 35, support is right now 27.80 and the ATMA. LMPX extending from yesterday and the day before was a day trade here. Consolidation exploded to 14.55. If he extends, my next target is 17 and 20, support today low and the ATM. Very volatile. Net is not making the move I need to see. So for me, this one still remains off the list. I need to see a move and hold above 40.10. We don't have that yet. So until that happens, this will move sideways or down. I liked the presence of the lower shadows, but it's making higher, a lower high and lower low. So that's a downtrend, right? Number volume picked up today, and the supports are 39 and 38. with the big volume show up yesterday, but it looks like it's drifting. So that's not good. This is not working. And for the past couple of days, it's been closing below the ATMA, and so this might come off the list. It's still holding. The secondary support at 2090, but you know this is not making the move we were projecting. Now remember this: we entered here, that looked like it was pushing through, fell, came down, held the secondary support, and I was getting frustrated with the secondary support flirting and not going anywhere. That was 2027. 2030, and then I say off the list. The following day, or a couple of days later, a week later, so did this, I pulled back, and then exploded, and to 23. So we looked like we wanted to go higher. We attempted an entry here near 22.50, something like that. It was breaking out, right? And then no, it's pulling back again. So this is a very difficult company to trade. It doesn't show the volume intraday that I need to see. It makes rallies on low volume. It pulls back on big volume. Anyway, it's all over the place. So bottom line is still holding the secondary support, but I'm not happy with what I'm seeing. It needs to come back above 22.30 to make a move. 24, 25, next target, 23.18, 25.70. OSTK continues to extend. They trade the consolidation, exploded today to my next target, 124. Now let's get a target of 140. We are very close to that. 139 and 153, if it does extend, the support is today low, and the ETMA, if you are swinging it. Pins, very disappointed. I mean, this had a massive blow, beautiful move. And that's what it did, consolidation, send the message that was pressing, there was good volume. And then this thing exploded, 38.23. To partial profit, and then immediately came down. We won, got a bounce. This looked good at this point. I mean, I didn't like this big Dunbar volume. This almost together, they're the same size as this bar. So whoever bought here sold immediately. And this thing came down hard. That point consolidated, broke 37. That was primary support. And from that point on, it went down, 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 and drifted. Look at this, down to 34. Crapola, right? Ugly. So this is now going down. Don't like it at all. And broke primary and secondary support off the list. It needs to come back to start working again. It needs to come back above 37. This is the risk of these volatile stocks. They give a lot of profit, but also reverse very quickly. I'm looking, an analyst gave a target of 44. At some point, I think we'll see it. But right now, this with this kind of technicals, looks like sure it's going to go lower. And the line in the sand, if you decide to hold it for some reason, is this 33.50, this low. Plug was mentioned multiple times. I never really issued an official alert. And then, because we selected others, there are only so many I can send you. And this exploded, reached the target at 13. Today came as high as 14.35. This was also day trade. And I sent a message to the group, if you ended up trading it, that was testing the channel top, time to take some profit. And if it does extend, however, it breaks above this double resistance at 1462. My targets are 16 and 18. Support right now is 13 and further down at the ATMA. We might see a retest of the area. That point could be a re-entry. Sell, I like the look of this chart a lot. In today's market, a little bit pullback. This is not untouched, basically. Sinus consolidation, breakout, volume is good. My first target is 38.67. This was mentioned yesterday. 40.60, 43, and 45.30. An analyst gave a target of 41. So some room for expansion. Snap inside the consolidation. I'm covering this because I like the technicals. I've improved. Today action was relatively bullish, and there's a big resistance here at the 50 simple, the moving average. Let's see if it crossed through the first of all, the trend line, and then 50. See what it does at that point. If it breaks out and holds and the volume increases green, bigger than yesterday, than today, and 3 days ago, looking for 2380 and 2577. SPWR looks like the solar are ready to make some move. They pop and pull back. Volume is good. Not a great close, but in green, better than pins, right? Resistance at 13. This is my first target. Above that, 1487 and 17. Support is the 8 May and this lows at 11. Surf, this is a new one. Breakout on good volume, 403.5 million trade shares. The reason for this alert is this big volume here. Big breakout, good consolidation, multi-month. And then today, pop through this trend line and these highs at 690, 688, 6. Another one, 673, so 688, giving entry opportunity at 690. So far it's looking good, it didn't get weakened compared to market. In fact, into an hour prior to the Fed's release, this popped and then it pulled back and weakened a little bit. Still holding the support. The intraday support was this line, these lows. See this low right there? That's your support. And currently, he held through the session. So that's positive, as well as the VWP right there. Now, this, let's see if volume comes in steady tomorrow. My first target is 8. There was a big seller today. Above that, 9.36, 11, and 12.79. By the way, since just because the seller was there today doesn't mean it's not there tomorrow. And the support, half of this candle, so 640, 650, and 590. PGT, they trade the target, fantastic move, broke out, a good run from the low at 140. We caught this early. 147, 148 area, good 5-6%, nice. Next target, with this kind of close, this is bullish, 157, 161, and 165. Support after today candle, 150, and today low, 146. Twitter, it broke out the good volume. I was watching this yesterday and for the past couple of days, I like this lower shaming decision today breakout. Could be a good swing, put in the swing idea channel, in the trading room. And my first target is, first of all, this high, 40.25, big resistance. If you blow through it, 41, 41, 44, 45, 43, 45, and 45.24. Support 38 and 36. And finally, Zillow reached the second target, pits them off. Still looks strong, it didn't weaken into the close. So that's positive. However, this is a resistance. So, you know, it's a good place to take some profit, at least, especially in today's action. What I'm looking for, if it breaks above this 85, 20, 10 area and holds, 91, 97, and 103. Support is 81 and 77. All right, folks, thanks for watching. Good trading. See you tomorrow.